Flanked by top opposition MPs, the leader of opposition Mathias Mpuuga, the shadow finance minister Mwanga Chivumbi, opposition chief whip John Baptist Nambeshe, National Unity Platform Party president Robert Kyagulanyi Ssentamu tore into the recently passed 3.5 trillion supplementary budget, saying it was wasteful and out of sync with the needs of ordinary Ugandans, citing the State House vote of 385 billion shillings. Kyagulanyi called out the government for being wasteful.
Supplementary budget last year of 77 billion, members of parliament were each bribed with 40 million shillings. Many of them denied it, but yes, some of them actually spoke the truth that they were given that money. This time they are giving every member of parliament 100 million shillings as a bribe to pass that supplementary.
During the briefing, it was also alleged that while MPs were given 100 million shillings each for passing the budget, Kyagulanyi was later joined by Mpuuga and Mwanga Chivumbi, who further condemned the government for wasteful expenditure. Mpuuga said the 100 million shillings was in the supplementary budget, but had not yet been picked by the MPs. He said the opposition in parliament raised a red flag on the illegal votes in the budget, but they were ignored.
That no member has picked money, but the money is in the supplementary. And we are raising a red flag to all and sundry that that money is illegally contained in the supplementary. Therefore, do not expect any member of parliament subscribe to the opposition to go or to get that money. If the money is in your account, our expectation is that you will return it to sender.
Sad as it is, the 3.5 trillion is going to be borrowed. So they are going to borrow 3.5 trillion to spend on things that are not so critical to the welfare of Ugandans, for which the president has talked about. And it's not going to be borrowed abroad. It's going to be borrowed internally. What it also means that the very people who steal our money are the ones going to lend us that money and earn a profit.
Kyagulanyi also responded to criticism over his media interview in the UK regarding the anti-homosexuality bill, saying the matter was being spinned out of context by government apologists.
I said that we grow and we transform. And as a leader, I am not calling for the killing or institutionalized targeting of some people as a leader. I might disagree with them, but I'm not calling for their killing.
Report compiled by David Tamale for the news.